Hello, Randall Monk and Ronna Vezane with another Archangel Michael. Oh, gem of wisdom.
Yeah. That sounds good.
Yeah, okay. All right. Endeavor to view life and circumstances around you with detachment. Be an observer and reserve judgment. Seek and live your own truth as it has been revealed to you.
We're talking about this a lot these days, and there's a reason for it. During these times of transition, as the higher frequency light begins to hit the dark, everything is being exposed. Nothing can stay hidden anymore. It's not that it's just people are worse, or situations are worse, or our world is in a worse condition. It's just that it was hidden and we weren't as aware. Not only are we coming into self-awareness, but with the technology that we have today, we have worldwide self-awareness of what's going on all over the world. Way back when I was small, it was all we had, the radio, and it was very limited. We had a very limited world, and it was very innocent. So this is, it's a good thing, but then it has its downside too, because if you are a worrywart, as my mother used to say, don't be a worrywart, whatever that means, you are worrying for about everything that happens, and there's nothing you can do about it. If you're worrying, you're adding to the problem. So the solution is, as Michael said, as we progress and as we grow in soul age, and as we learn to use the universal laws, we are manifesting much faster. And we say this over and over again, the most important thing you can do now is to, when your mind starts to wander and you go into those downward spirals, return to center, become neutral, and observe from a higher vantage point. You've heard us say that many times, but it's so important. We send love and blessings to everyone. Did you hear me? Everyone. Those who are creating the good and those who are out there causing all the negativity, because they are doing what they're supposed to do. A lot of those have chosen to be the bearers of that negativity and to bring it all out. And so it isn't our job to judge. So if you can become non-judgmental, you can have an opinion, but quite often it's better to keep it to yourself. You can be aware, but try to be neutral about what's going on, because we really don't understand complete. We don't have the whole picture. And so what you think and what you send out, the law of the circle and the infinity, is what you're adding energy to. So are you adding to the difficulties, or are you sending the love light that is beginning to have a really big effect on it? Think about that. Change yourself. Change your inner world. And your reality will change, and it will connect with those of like mind, and we will make a difference. That is the secret. It's one of the biggest trials and tests we have now. It isn't easy, it's a tough one, but we can do it. Try it.
Thank you, Ronna. So this quote is about detachment, about being an observer. And one of the most important things about being an observer, to become an observer, to not get caught up in the drama, is to be present in the moment. To be mindful, because when we're present in the moment, we are aware of our thoughts. Like Ronna said, return to center. Well, if our thoughts are running wild, we're not able to return to center because we're on automatic. The wheels are just turning and turning, and we're just going along as we normally would. However, when we're mindfully in the moment, then we're aware of our thoughts, what's going on. And I'm not saying to stop the thoughts. I'm just saying be aware of the thoughts and be non-judgmental. Oh, that was bad, or that was good. Just be aware of it and let it go. Don't judge the thought. Don't judge the circumstances around your environment. Just observe the environment, observe what's going on. And what if we don't do that, our thoughts go wild and our emotions go wild right along with them. So when we're observing, when we're present in the moment, then we can we're aware of those emotions before they go just like that. And we are controlling our emotions rather than our emotions controlling us. And I'm not saying to stop emotions. I'm saying, again, don't judge them, just observe them. And when we observe them, they kind of fade away. So it's a matter of being observing.
One more thing too. That's why it's really good to take a bath in the violet flame every evening, see the violet flame blazing up around you, so that any discordant energies mm-hmm. we have sent out are going to be automatically cleared.
That's true.
And so that we are being pure in our intention, and we're always sending out positive vibes, and that is so needed.
Very true. So if we use that in violet flame, when we use that violet flame as we're going to sleep, before we go to sleep, then we're negating any negative karma, any cause and effect from anything we may have created during that day, so that we go to sleep at a neutral point.
We're more powerful than we know.
Yes, we are.
We love you.
Much love, many blessings. Bye for now.